Prepared. Prepared. But Americans don't say it like we say, just prepared.
I'm putting two things together.
I'm NXT superstar Candice LeRae. I have a degree in culinary arts, and I used to be a baker at a universally known theme park. Let's get cooking.
Hi again. I hope you watched the other three prior to this one. We're doing some things together because we can't really go in the world, and we can't go to a restaurant right now. We can't go to a bakery and go in and dine. Fun fact, I don't just have a baking degree. I actually have a full culinary background, and I am a savory person. So, my favorite word, we're gonna make buffalo chicken mac and cheese.
So here's what you need: 2 tablespoons flour, 4 tablespoons butter divided, 2.5 cups half and half, 1/4 cup buffalo sauce, some chicken, lots of chicken or little chicken, up to you, 1.5 pounds of cheese, 1 pound of macaroni, and 1 cup of panko. To start, we'll preheat the oven to 350 degrees.
Tegan doesn't necessarily love spicy stuff.
I'm trying to be an adult and force myself.
The good thing about cooking is it's not like baking where it has to be a science and not every single ingredient has to be measured out exactly. So if we kind of tweak things a little bit so it's not so spicy, that's not a problem. When I do different mac and cheeses, I try to find cheese that complements each other but then also complements whatever I want the mac and cheese to be. I want something with a little kick to it, so I always like to use pepper jack. And then I love sharp, extra sharp white cheddar. We're not gonna use as much pepper jack, but we're gonna use a lot of cheddar. Can you just cut them into little blocks that we can melt? Oh, I guess everything is over here, so. Good news. The chicken and all that already took care of. But I wanted you to learn how to do this sauce. 2.5 cups. I hope it's all the rest of it. Oh, that's ready for us. We need it. And then we're going to add this buffalo sauce. And you can use whatever kind of buffalo sauce you want. And honestly, if you want to get crazy at home, you can use a barbecue sauce.
What?
Did you just get scared?
That's a lot of spice.
It's not gonna be that bad. Because on top of all of this, we're also adding cheese to the mix. Are you ready to make your first roux?
Let's do it.
All right. And it's equal parts fat, which is either butter or oil, and flour.
Is there a preference?
I don't necessarily have a preference. I just find a lot of times I'm a fan of butter.
Yep.
And if I can use butter in things, I'm gonna use butter in things.
So
again,
I can have oil in my house, and I have butter.
You're more likely, you can use oil. But we have butter, so we're gonna use butter. So like I told you before, I'm gonna take this from you, and since this is wrapped up, it's okay. We need 2 tablespoons. As we said in a previous episode, if you watched it, you know. If you didn't,
what are you doing? Just watch it. It's not hard.
Butter, no, it's not. It's really easy. Butter will tell you how many tablespoons, how many cups, and it makes your life a lot easier. So we only need 2 tablespoons.
Okay.
We're gonna melt the butter first. And what you're gonna want is you're gonna wanna mix it together. because it needs to look like wet sand on the beach. And I'm gonna add just a little bit, not the whole thing. And this was one of the things that, like, when I watch shows, they always just added it all. But when you add just a little bit, it kind of thickens a little faster.
So we got to a boiling point. It's pretty, it's a good consistency right now. It's thicker, like a more of a saucy consistency, but it's gonna get even more saucy because we're about to add the cheese.
So saucy.
You can go ahead now, and it's almost like making your own little fondue. Do you know what fondue is?
I know what fondue is. Have I had it before? No.
We're gonna do a layer of the pasta and the chicken and all the goodness down there, because in a minute our cheese is gonna be completely ready. All the lumps of cheese have gone down. And now we're going to get to bring the cheese to the party. I know.
Just really love cheese.
And then I'm gonna do a little bit more. I just want every little bit of cheese, don't you want all the cheese?
Yeah.
Oh my God, it's gonna be so good. Spread this out. Have you gone to a restaurant and ordered mac and cheese and had like crispy, crunchy topping on the mac and cheese? Oh. Go ahead and sprinkle that delicious goodness on.
How much?
Again, all of it. Yep, literally all of it. This is gonna change your life. Well, we are gonna put this in the oven and then wash our hands because we've just touched a lot of things. And then, as long as like 30, 40 minutes, I think. Mac and cheese is ready to come out of the oven. Once you pull the mac and cheese out of the oven, you gotta let it set for 10 minutes.
Wow.
The meat looks beautiful and the mac and cheese looks lovely. Oh my God, it smells so good.
It's all crunchy.
Mmm. Once it sets, we're gonna cut it, put it on plates, and then we're gonna eat it. Somewhat smallish portions.
Somewhat smallish,
that is not that much.
That could feed a family of 12, that one.
This whole tray, yes. Are you ready?
Yeah, thank you.
Doof, doof. It's spicy. Mm-mm. It's not bad, right?
No. No. It's the right amount of spice. Got a little kick.
And it's delicious.
Fancy and delicious.
And now you know how to make it yourself. So if you wanted to, you could do it yourself at home. Mm. And you, watching, you could do it yourself at home. Please remember, please, I know you're probably getting like, oh, why did she say this? But this is actually very important. Wash your hands. You should wash your hands while you're cooking food for friends and family, and maybe yourself as well.
Just don't be disgusting.
Don't wash your hands. And if you're watching this now in these times, cooking, baking, these are things that you can do at home, and you don't have to worry about going out. CDC recommends it, I recommend it, Tegan recommends it, and this buffalo chicken mac and cheese.
Yeah, it does.
Recommends you stay home and make this.
Yeah, it's not gonna be as good as this, but.
It might be.
No.
Make it yourself.
Yeah.
Tag it,
Or tag it. You should hashtag it. Hashtag it.
Why not?
Hashtag buffalo mac and cheese. Also, just tag us. Us. Actually, Candice, at Candice LeRae.
At Tegan Knox, WWE underscore.
Let us know. Show us what you did. Show us what you did. Maybe you put corn gonzola.
I'll do this too. And just eat it all.
I'll get there.